If you're looking to rent or purchase your next cinema camera, you may be having to decide between two main types, a camcorder and a digital cinema camera. What are the strengths and weaknesses of each, and which one should you get? In this video, we're going to check that out. First, we have our camcorder. This is kind of prosumer, but depending on which one you get. The one that we have here comes in at about $3,000, and they're a lot cheaper than compared to your digital cinema cameras. One of the main features of these cameras is that they come pretty much everything you need all put together. We've got a top handle with zoom and record, but we've also got XLR ports, so we've got full professional audio that can even output 48 volt phantom power, so no need for an external recorder. Now the preamps probably aren't the best, but it does work if you're going run and gun and you're starting off. We've also got a nice integrated lens. Depending on which camera you get, it may have a lens, it may not, but the ones that do come built in are fairly good, and they even have some pretty crazy zoom. I believe this one goes up to 21 times, which is just crazy for any type of lens. As for recording formats, this can do MOV, MP4, AVC HD, and with an external recorder, we can get ProRes. This camcorder right here records up to 4K, but we can also get a couple of other ones that go up to 60 frames per second 4K, but you don't usually find many that go above that 4K limit, where these ones can go really high. The built-in screen is nice because we can get our picture right on there without a need for another monitor. And overall, this is a great option if you need to go lightweight, because this camera is pretty small, not the smallest, but compared to this, it's small, it's light, and it's great for if you're going to be on the go and need a camera that has everything you need in a small compact package. Now we've got this. This is your digital cinema camera that has all the features you could ever want, but it comes at a cost. This camera right here comes in $20,000 with all of its accessories included, and the accessories are not cheap either. The screen is $2,000. If you want to get storage, it's another $850, but they are extremely great cameras. It's very heavy and solid, which is why you wouldn't want to go handheld with it, but the images you get out of these are amazing. Specifically from RED, you can record up to 8K. This one right here goes up to 5K, which is kind of low end for this, but still, we don't even have a 5K TV at all, so this one's pretty good. And it's very expandable and modular. On the back of these cameras, we have mounting points with all of these pins, so we can put on different accessories, say we need XLR or maybe SDI to live stream. And then we've also got a handle on the side with all these controls. And you can mount your screen pretty much anywhere you want because, well, it's not built in and it's extra. So if you're looking for an all-in-one package, the camcorder is definitely the way to go. But if you want to get something that is modular, expandable, this is definitely your option. But there is one thing that everybody has to get, and that is storage and batteries. For your camcorder right here, it mainly records off of SD cards, more specifically these. This is your SDXC card, and that's what this shoots on. Some camcorders may use a Canon CFast card, but for the most part, some sort of SD card similar to the size. These are pretty cheap. This one has to have a fast card because it records 4K, but for about an hour's worth of footage, it's like $50, so not that bad. The batteries for this are also pretty small. This is the battery. You can get about two and a half, three hours worth of use out of this battery. And if you go off brand like I did, this is only $20. So to keep this juiced and recording, it's pretty cheap. Now let's say we want to record on this. Well, it depends on your recording size. In 4K on this Red Scarlet, and using 120 gigabyte SSD, we get about an hour's worth of footage. And that's another difference between these two cameras, is we have a tiny SD card, where here we have a $1,000 SSD. And that's the same across all digital cinema cameras, no matter if it's from RED, Arri, or Canon. Also, to keep this camera running, we have to have a battery. Now, our RED that we have right here has this handle with a fancy little battery compartment, but RED no longer sells these batteries, which means that we have to keep it juiced up a different way using this. This is a $300 V-mount battery, which mounts to the back of your camera or using a belt clip, however you want it. It works on this camera too, but You got batteries in there, so why not use that? So this can get you about an hour and a half to 2 hours worth of use, which is not a lot. They're heavy, they're big, and expensive at the same time. And another thing worth taking note of is that digital cinema cameras can record RAW, which will allow you greater flexibility in post to change things like white balance and ISO, but also the best possible image quality, where you don't really find that type of feature on these camcorders. So which camera should you get? It's not that easy of a decision. I use both of these all the time for different needs. If I need to get something out quick, I go for usually an all-in-one solution, which is this. But if I want the best quality possible, or if I'm sitting down in front of the camera, this is a great option as well. I prefer using the bigger cinema cameras when we're in a studio or maybe on a controlled set where there's not a lot of movement. But if I need to be following the talent a lot, or we're going to be moving around all the time, this is definitely a great option because it's all in one and it's lightweight. In order to get audio, we have to either get a module for this, or we have to get a bunch of adapters and boxes in order to get audio into here, where this just has an XLR port built in. So this is kind of an all-in-one solution that's better for those that are just starting out, or maybe somebody that needs to be on the go a lot. But there you go. Those are some of the features of both cameras and which one you should pick up. If you like this video, leave a like and hit that subscribe button for more videos like this. This is Mark with Apple Tech One Tweet, and I will see you in the next one.